rated TBP 2 people power.
How is everybody doing?
Alright, we're gonna get some stuff done up in here.
So, today's episode is focused on four people whose art I've really come to admire and appreciate more than pretty much almost anyone else in ways that people would never understand. And here's the thing, hear me out. There's this person named Beck Key, real name Rebecca Bird, and she has been a deviant artist for nearly 15 years now. This year would be her 15th year. And she's got a gallery full of art that is literally that good. And I don't just say this to say it. I say this because it's true. 100%. Grade A quality. And let me tell you people something.
Let me tell you people something.
So, bottom line is this. Over the last 15 years, she has perfected her style in such a way that it's almost as if she's overcome her colorblindness. And you know, I say that she's colorblind because, well, she was diagnosed with it at such and such an age, and of course, nobody knows why, but that hasn't stopped her any. That hasn't slowed her down any. And you know what? Truthfully, I admire that a lot about her. And this particular, how you say, gallery is so intense and so rich with humoristic, dark comedy and blunt honesty that it's almost as if, well, she's developed her own style, and rightfully so, you know? Because the rest, as they say, that's history. And she even makes plushes, she makes artisan crafts and stuff. She even did a few redesigns of a few of her characters. And I'm gonna show you these redesigns right now. And, well, this is, well, this, I know for sure, is undisputedly a couple of them. Now, check this out. You're not gonna believe this. That's her character, Clint Darkson. He got a pretty cool redesign after nearly a decade or so. This is another one of her characters from Lunatic's Tale, Mia. And her design is much different from, say, 10 years ago. This is her new design for her character Polly, also from Lunatic's Tale. And then, of course, the rest of the Marcia Lee. Like this, and that, and that, and that, and so on. And this is, of course, one of the villains in Lunatic's Tale, Lynch. He's one of the crewers. Supposedly one of the only three crewers left in existence, supposedly. And God knows why, but
I don't care about it.
And this is, of course, Malcolm Quimby. He's the teenage king who became king after his father died when Malcolm himself was only 5. You can see how much it's taken a toll on him. Now, this is, of course, another character she redesigned named Troy. He's also a part of the Mercy Elite. And check this out. Since then, she sporadically submitted deviations to her gallery, but each time she does, her art gets better and better and better and better. And I'm just gonna say that right now. And her husband, of course, is Richard Fortner, otherwise known by his name King Rick on DeviantArt. You know? And let me just say this, okay? Let me point out here. This guy, he might not be able to draw past stick figures or whatever, but this guy is an amazingly talented guy. He's got a YouTube channel based on his gaming sessions called Timed Hits. And you know what's funny? What's funny is that his YouTube channel also features a few of his friends. And this guy, you know, he might not be able to draw past stick figures, but his art style is so unique that it needs no explanation, because it's literally that original. He's got a special style about him, you know? And I'm just being truthful about it. I can't lie to you people. The guy's a good person. He's a great artist, too. Especially when it comes to his gaming sessions. And there's this one that I liked most of all on this Time Hits YouTube channel. And it was about his run-through of the SNES version of, I think it was Looney Tunes Acme Animation Factory or whatever. But, yeah. I mean, not that it means anything, but, you know. And let me just say, this guy, he's got it. Undisputed, he's got it. No question, no doubt. And check this out. This is good. Look at the humor behind this. This is so awesome. And, oh look, he's got photography. That's great. I like his photography too. Very good pictures that he takes. And I remember him doing a selfie once. I don't know exactly where that is, but if I could guess, per se, if I could just guess what one of his selfies would look like, it would look something like, say, this. I'm telling you though, seriously, that's a good selfie. That is legit. Truly legit. And another one of his selfies. And this guy, he's got a really, really good sense of humor. So good, in fact, you might even say he's well ahead of his time, like Seth MacFarlane and Matt Groening. You know? But that's one thing, isn't it? That's one thing. Like, and check this out. Another one of their friends from the ZiBariCrew's, as I call them. This, of course, is, you know, of course, Rebecca Burgess. They call her Bex because she's from England. But she is primarily responsible, I think, in the coloring department, or is it the line art department, for this webcomic called Headcase. And this particular comic is absolutely mind-boggling to me. It's a perfect accurate representation of life through my eyes, in ways that I might have never even imagined. And she has a really unique gallery of her own. And it's crazy, because, I mean, check this out. Look at her artwork. This is what I'd like to call true unfiltered genius. And I like this picture of hers where she draws Mozart, you know, directing one of his own symphonies and stuff. But to me, this is one of her best works, undisputedly, without question. And of course, here's another one of her artworks. And this is also a fan art of this guy. And she's extremely talented at what she does. Extremely. There's no other way to say it. She's just that good. She's that good. And here's another fan art of hers. Another fan art. Right here. Oh, by the way, Mozart recently turned how old? Because, you know, I think he was born in, say, 1762, I think. So that would make him 256 years old today. 255-ish. What the hell would I know? But the point is actually simple enough. This particular artist, she's got a style of her own, and yet it completely relates to the life stories of people like, say, myself. You know? And there's another guy who is also a part of the ZiBariCrew. His name is Nicholas Meyer. He goes by the name Nick Meyer. And his DeviantArt username is HolyLancer9, with a capital H. And this guy hasn't necessarily made much artwork for his verboten comic, but that's only in the last couple of years, because this guy, let me tell you, he might have been on some sort of extended hiatus for whatever reason, but this guy, he's got it. This guy is a special talent of his own, and he's also one of the four people, the other three I just mentioned earlier in this video, who inspired me to create my own comic book entitled Confessions of a Sociopath. And it's so good that they're so talented, and they're such an inspiration to me, that I even decided upon coming up with a new suggested logo for them for their ZiBariCon website way back in, say, 2012-ish, I think. Yeah, 2013. And I have an art style of my own. I used to be a very, very, very top-notch traditional artist. Until, of course, I turned to digital. And then, of course, the rest, as they say, is history, and I look back at it. This is how good my traditional art was back then. This is how good my digital art is now. Take a look at this, huh? Take a look at this. And I even do photo manipulations too, like this parody of Squidward's bathroom session being interrupted. Look at that! Oh my god, man. What is that? What is that? But anyway, that's pretty much it. So if you like what I do, don't hesitate to subscribe to any of my channels online. Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube, Plus, Gmail, Tumblr, and Instagram. I'm all over the map! So until next time, you take care of yourselves.
Jerry Springer Reference!